गुड इवनिंग राशि, गुड इवनिंग नन, होप यू गाइस कैन सी मी एंड हियर मी। ओके, सो आई होप यू गाइस हैव बीन एंजॉयिंग माय क्लासेस व्हिच आई हैव बीन टेकिंग ड्यूरिंग द डे विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एलआर। सो आई एम रनिंग अ कंप्लीट बैच ऑन एलआर, ऑन अन अकेडमी एंड a few students there requested to do some practice questions, so to say, as far as LRDI is concerned, and that's essentially the reason why I started taking these classes. For those of you who don't know me, who might be joining me for the first time, my name is Ravi Handa. I've been teaching for CAT for close to 15 years now. I've taught 20,000 plus students online, and recently I started taking classes on An Academy as well. As a part of An Academy, I'm taking classes on YouTube, special classes much like this one, and the paid course on An Academy that I'm running for LR. Now, you guys can join my Telegram group on CAT Prep Online. Let me just share that with you, the link for my Telegram group. So I, request you to follow me on An Academy. If you have already signed up for it, you can follow me on An Academy. And other than that, what you can also do is join my Telegram group, because what happens is either me or someone from my team, we keep posting updates about abhi ye class hai, then we have a class at 7, we have a class at 5, and we cover all of that, give you all the necessary links in our Telegram group. Me or someone from our team will continue to do that. So that's the benefit. Now, for those of you who are not aware, at An Academy, I'm currently running a plus course. Which is dedicated to LR. Now, what happens in a plus course is you get things in a structured way. That is, you do this, then this, then this. It follows a particular methodology. There is also an iconic plan. And in the iconic plan, what happens is you get personalized guidance from top mentors. The subscription for CAT is for 16,400. That's the plan that I recommend. You don't need more than 6 month. CAT is not that far away. And if you have not subscribed to it yet, you can use the coupon code HANDA. The coupon code HANDA will offer you a 10% discount over and above these prices. So if there are any questions about preparation strategy or anything like that, please let me know. I can start a discussion around them. And in case nothing like that is there, then I'll start off with the questions. So if you want me to start off with the questions, give me a thumbs up. If you have any doubts, you can use the chat window and we can get started with that. Good evening, Shruti. Rashi, if you are targeting CAT 2022, my main recommendation to you would be try to build a habit of reading an hour a day. That's the most important thing, and that's the best thing that you can do for your preparation. Because, you know, LRDI, math, there are formulas that I can teach you or any teacher can teach you. It doesn't require too much effort to improve in quant. It doesn't require too much effort to improve in LRDI. On the other hand, it requires a lot of effort to improve in verbal. And the only possible way to do that, it's like losing weight. Suppose you want to learn how to type or you want to lose weight. If you want to learn how to type, there are particular finger placements that you need to do. You do a little bit of practice, you will improve. For losing weight, you need to constantly exercise. There is no technique that anyone can teach you with that. And that's the reason why I recommend anyone who's targeting CAT 2022 to read as much as they can, as often as they can. Rashi, are you still in college? As in, are your exams? Okay, so in that case, first priority should be getting good marks in graduation, because no good B school will accept you if you have low marks in graduation. So that should be another one of your priorities. Hi Anshuk, good to see you here. Okay, I think we are good to go ahead now. So this is a question I believe Kishle had sent. A shopping mall has a large basement parking with parking slots painted in it along a single row. These slots are narrow. Compact car can fit in a single slot, but an SUV requires two slots. When a car arrives, the parking attendant guides the car to the first available slot from the beginning of the row into which the car can fit. For our purpose, the cars are numbered. So basically, so this is something like this. So these are the slots, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose car 1 comes in, it's a compact car, it'll come in, it'll go here. Then car 2 comes in, which is a SUV. Now SUV will need two slots, so it will go here and occupy 2 and 3. That's essentially how it is happening. Cars are numbered according to the order that they arrive in. The first car to arrive is given a number 1, second a number 2, and so on. The numbering does not indicate whether the car is a compact or an SUV. So we don't know what type of a car it is. The configuration of the parking lot is a sequence of the car numbers in each slot. Each vacant slot is indicated by the letter V. So if you see a letter V, that means that slot is empty. So slot 1, 2, 3, there must be cars here. So one is here, car 2 is occupying these two positions. This slot is V, which is empty. Hi Abhishek, good to see you here. Bob the Builder has joined the class. Now, for those of you who don't really know the reference to it, it's probably because you don't have kids. I have a 7-month-old who keeps listening to the Bob the Builder songs day in and day out. It can get really, really annoying. I'm surprised that someone, who is a cat aspirant knows who or what Bob the Builder is. Okay, going ahead. Oh, Rashi, that must have been a long time ago then. For instance, suppose cars numbered 1 through 5 arrive where cars 1, 3 and 5 are compact cars, 2 and 4 are SUVs. At this point, the parking lot would be described by the sequence as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So at this point, basically, I have cars 1, 3 and 5 are compact, 2 and 4 are SUVs, and these 5 have come. So what are my slots like? So my slots are, first there will be 1, then the next 2 slots will be occupied by 2 because it is an SUV, then there will be 3. Then the next 2 slots will be occupied by 4 because it is an SUV. And then there will be 5. This is the current status. If cars 2 and 5 now vacate their slots. So now cars 2 and 5 have vacated their slots. So you have 1 vacant, 3, 4, and vacant. This is the next step. 1 vacant, 3, 4, and obviously everything after 4 is vacant, so there is no need to put an extra V here. If a compact car number 6 arrives, subsequently followed by an SUV numbered 7. So now car 6 comes in. So where will 6 go? 6 will come in and occupy this position, and then car 7 will come in and 7 will occupy 2 positions here because 7 was an SUV. Are you guys okay with this arrangement? Lag. Hello guys, can you see me and hear me clearly? It looks green at my end. Okay, are you guys okay with this arrangement? 1 6 blank, 1 6 blank, 3 4 4 7 7. 4 4 is for the SUV, which is 4. 7 7 is for the SUV, which is 7. I'll repeat. Kishle, are you okay till here? 1 blank blank, 3 4 4, because 2 has gone out and 5 has gone out. Now car 6 comes in and 7 is an SUV that comes in. Now, if 6 comes in, which position will it occupy? 6 will occupy this position, which was blank. This will continue to remain blank. Now, 7 comes in. 7 needs 2 slots. 7 needs 2 slots. 7 cannot come here. So, the 2 slots where 7 will come will be at the end, and that will be 7, 7. Are you okay with this now? 7, 7, 1, 6, blank, 3, 4, 4, 7, 7. Which is what is given to me. 1, 6, vacant, 3, 4, this is an SUV, so it is 2 slots. 7, which is an SUV, so this is 2 slots. Okay, can I go ahead with the questions now? Shivani, the voice is not coming. I believe the problem might be at your end because others can hear me. If everyone is okay till here, if you can see me clearly, everything is fine, please give me a thumbs up. Then I'll move on to the questions. Okay. Now, this is a random arrangement that we have done. Then, initially, cars 1, 2, 3 and 4 arrive, among which 1 and 4 are SUVs, while 2 and 3 are compact cars. So, what will be the first starters? 1 is an SUV, so 1, 1. Then 2 and 3 are compact. Then 4 is an SUV. So, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. This will be the status at level 1, first thing. Next, what happens is, car 1 then leaves. Okay. So, if car 1 then leaves, it will be 2 blanks. Then 2, 3, 4, 4. Followed by arrival of car 5, which is a compact car. So, then 5 comes in. 5 blank. 2, 3, 4, 4. And 6, which is an SUV. So, then 6 comes in. Now, 6 cannot go at this empty position. 6 cannot go at this empty position. So, it will be 5, 3, 5, blank, 2, 3, 4, 4, 6, 6. Are you okay till here? So, from car 1 to SUV, I've done it in red. From car 1 to SUV, I've done it in red. Let me use a different color now on car 4 then leaves. If car 4 then leaves, 5 blank, 2, 3, blank, blank, 6, 6, 4 has left. Then car 7, an SUV comes. Now 7, the SUV which comes, it cannot come at this position because it is an empty slot. Then 2, 3, 7 is an SUV, so 7, 7, 6. And car 8, a compact car arrives. The car 8, which is a compact car which is arriving, car 8 can fit here. Car 8 can fit here. At this moment, among the following, which car is next to 3? So, at this moment, this is my final arrangement. This is my final arrangement. What is next to 3? 2 is next to 3. 7 is next to 3. Only 7 is there in the options. So 7 is my answer. Answer is option A or 7. Kishle, Shruti, Shreya, Rajesh, all of you have answered this correctly. Kishle is the one who sent this, who told me to discuss these questions. And as a matter of fact, if there are any LRDI questions, see guys, along with the course which I'm teaching on an academy, you guys can join that. Use coupon code HANDA to join the course, to subscribe to it. But let's say if there are any particular LRDI sets, what I'm doing in these episodes is I'm discussing good quality questions. That's my aim with these evening episodes. Because, you know, I'm pretty much against the kind of books which are there, as well as mocks and material, because they have A, either too difficult stuff, or B, too easy stuff which doesn't get asked in the exam. So my goal with these episodes is maybe I'll do just 2 sets or 3 sets in a particular class, but I'll do stuff. But I'll do stuff which is, relevant to the exam. That's my goal with these classes. So if you want to send any particular sets, please feel free to do that. My mail ID, if you want to send across a set, okay, sir, can you discuss it in the next one? You can send it to ravianda@gmail.com. Just mention in that email that you want it to be discussed in the episodes or the must do LR DI classes. Just mention that in the email so that I know which class you want me to pick it up in. Okay, going back to the question at hand. So this was one. Telegram channel won't work, man. There are so many messages. I hardly get to track that. My Telegram channel, if you want to join that, where I keep on posting updates about it, it is here. Telegram. Let me share the link. Okay, let me pin this as well. So Bob, you can join it. I'll be thrilled to have you in the group as well. Okay. Now, suppose 8 cars have arrived, of which 2 have left. I don't know which 8 have arrived. I don't know which have left, because I don't know which ones were SUVs, which ones were, which order they were in and stuff like that. Also, suppose car 4 is a compact car and car 7 is an SUV. Which of the following is a possible configuration? So if I can see from something like this, in most of them, what I'm able to see is that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the first positions are typically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello, guys, can you see me and hear me? Okay, I think I saw Skisley's message. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Definitely, I would have started with this. We would have started with this, with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Some of them might be double, some of them might be single. I don't know about that. And now, I don't see in any of the configurations, I'm not seeing 1 and I'm not seeing 4. Which means, very clearly, 1 and 4 have left. 1 and 4 have left. I have 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1 and 4 have left. So, after this should be the status. This should be the status. 1, 2, 3, blank 5. Now, if this is the status for the first 5, then which of the following can it lead to? 6 comes here. Okay. Then 7. If 7 comes after this, it will either go to the first position. If 7 comes after this, this is blank, it will either go here or it will go in the end. Then 8 comes. 8 comes. 8 will go here. So 8, 2, 3, blank, 5, 6, 7 is possible, because 7 is an SUV. 7 is an SUV. So 7 will occupy 2 positions. 4 was a compact car, so 4 would have vacated only 1 slot. 4 was a compact car, so 4 would have vacated only 1 slot. 1, I don't know whether 1 was a compact or was an SUV. 1 was a compact or an SUV. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, they came in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, they came in one after the other. Then 8 came in. 8 occupied the slot which was the first one. Left the fourth one, which is a compact car, so it left just one vacant slot, making option 4 as the answer here. Are you guys okay with this? Please give me a thumbs up if you are fine with this arrangement. If you have any doubts, please ask. Last point. So, now, there is a single 7. So, let's keep double 7. What I'm saying is, 4 is a compact car, 7 is an SUV. I'll assume all are compact. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. This is the status. If all cars came in now, two cars need to go out. Two cars need to go out. Which two will you remove? Definitely in any of the arrangements, I don't see one. So I remove one. In any of the arrangements, I don't see four. So I'll remove four. And then I have 5, 6, 7, 7. Then 8 needs to come in. 8 needs to come in. 8 will occupy the first empty slot. So 8, 2, 3. This is vacant. Since car 4 was a compact, I know for sure that it will be just one vacant slot. And then 5, 6, 7, 7. So 8, 2, 3. Vacant 5, 6, 7, 7. Making 4 as the answer. I know 4 is vacant because 2 cars have left. I don't know which 2 have left. I don't know which 2 have left. But if I look at the options, if I look at the options, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 and 8 are there in all the options. So 1 and 4 have to be the ones which have left. 7 is 1 only. 7, I am writing it twice because I don't want a confusion between a compact car. They are not going to write the 7 twice. I am writing 7 twice for clarity purpose that 7 is an SUV. They will not write it twice. If you look at this arrangement, 7 was an SUV car. They will write it only once. They will write it only once. In this one, 2 and 4 were SUVs. They will write it only once. I write it as 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5 so that I have clarity on it. Let's look at the third one. Suppose the sequence at some point of time is 4, 5, 6, V3. Now, if it is 4, 5, 6, blank, N3, that means that there must have been empty spaces. I don't know how many, but there must have been lots of empty spaces when car number 4 came in. Because if there were no empty spaces, it would have gone in after this. When car 4 came in, there must have been empty spaces before 3. When car 5 came in, then also there must have been empty spaces before 3, otherwise it will go after. When car 6 came in, there must have been empty spaces before 3. And there is still one more space. How is that possible? So before 3, you need actually a minimum of 4 empty spaces before 3, minimum, or maybe even more. What if 4 is an SUV? If 4 is an SUV, or 5 is an SUV, or 6 is an SUV, then 2 for this, 2 for this, 2 for this, and 1, you will need 7 empty spaces. That's not possible. The only way you can get 4 empty spaces before 3 is if 1 was an SUV occupying 2 positions, 2 was an SUV occupying 2 positions, and then I had a 3. Then 1 and 2 left. So this became the status. 1 and 2 left, this became the status. Then 4 came in, 5 came in, 6 came in, they occupied the first 3 empty. 1 still remains vacant, and then we have a 3. So what do I know for sure? I know 1 has to be an SUV. I know 2 has to be an SUV. Only then you will get 4 empty places. Very similarly, I know 4, 5 and 6 have to be compact. Because if any of them was an SUV, they would have occupied 2 positions. So now 3 is an SUV. About 3 I don't know. Could be anything. 4 is a compact, yes. 1 is an SUV, yes. 5 is a compact, yes. About 4, 5 and 6, I am sure that they are compacts. About 1 and 2, I am sure they are SUVs. Only about 3, I am not sure. 3 can be a compact, 3 can be an SUV. So, which one am I not sure of? Which one is not necessarily true? 3, that 3 is an SUV. That is something which is not necessarily true. Are you okay with this? Going ahead. Now, suppose that car 4 Is it possible for a car to leave and then come back again? No, Shreya. If it leaves, see, we are talking about car's entry. So if it leaves, if it is coming after car number 7, then it becomes car number 8. It may have been car 4 before. Now it will become car number 8 because in the question itself, we are given cars are numbered according to the order they arrive at the lot. So suppose I drive a car, I go in, I'm right now car number 2. I left. And before I came back, 10 more cars had come in. So then my number will be 13. Initially, I was 2. 10 more after me took it to 12. My car number would have changed to 13. It is not a number plate which will remain static. It is the nth car which is entering the parking lot. So the same car can come back, but it will not have the same nth entry point. Suppose that car 4 is not the first car to leave and the sequence at the time between the arrival of car 7 and car 8, okay, is V7, 3, 6 and 5. So what does this mean? This tells me multiple things. One, it tells me is that what are the cars that have left? What are the cars that have left? Can you tell me? 4 has left for sure because it is given. Someone else must have left before 4. 1 and 2 have also left before 4. 1 and 2 have also left before 4. So let me say when I start 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This would have been the order. This would have been the order. Initially for the first 5. Then I know that 4 is not the first car to leave. I know that 4 is not the first car to leave. One of these two left. One of these two left. Which one do you want to leave first? I'll consider two cases. In one case, 1 goes first. It's 2, 3, 4, 5. In the next case, 2 goes first. And then I have 1, 3, 4, 5. After that, what happens? 6 needs to come in and we know 6 is coming in at the position of 4. So now I will make, suppose 4 leave. And in this case, I'm making 4 leave. Now look at it. 6 comes in. At this stage, 6 comes in at this stage in both of them. In both of them, 6 comes in. Ideally, 6 should occupy the first position, 6, 2, 3, blank 5. And in this case, it would have been 1, 6, 3, blank 5. But that is not happening. That is not happening. 6 is not occupying this position, 6 is not occupying this position, but 6 is occupying this position. How is that possible? How is that possible? That 6 will not occupy the first position or the second position, but 6 occupies the position between 3 and 5. How can that happen? Shreya is absolutely right. This is only possible if both 4 and 6 are SUVs. If both 4 and 6 are SUVs, only in that case, let me draw the diagram. So 2, 3, 2 blank positions and 5 were there, or 1 blank position 3. One of these cases must have happened. One of these cases must have happened, and that is why 6 comes and occupies this. That is why 6 comes and occupies this. Are you okay with this? That both 4 and 6 are SUVs, that is why they leave one blank position. That is why they leave one blank position. Then what happens? I need vacant 7. Vacant and 7. Okay. Now what I am going to do is, 2 should not be there in my final arrangement. 1 should not be there in my final arrangement. So I'll make this blank blank. 3665. I'll make this blank blank 3665. Both of them have become the same. Both of them have become the same. I know for a fact that the first one which left, that was a compact car. This position which was vacant, it was because it was a compact car. This position, it was vacant, this was a compact car. But I don't know about this. This could have been an SUV also. This could have been an SUV also. Here, this could have been an SUV also, which means another possible arrangement is three blanks and then 3665. So if this car is an SUV, then it will leave two vacant spots. If this car is an SUV, then it can leave two vacant spots, one older one and 3665. So this is possible. About 1 and 2 we do not know. And then 7 comes in. Now, when 7 is coming in, it is not occupying the first position. But it is occupying the second position. How is that possible? When 7 is coming in, it is not occupying the... Yeah, even if it is an SUV, it will occupy the first two. So how is it that the first position remains vacant? Shreya is absolutely right. The first position can remain vacant if and only if, let me just remove this. First position can remain vacant if and only if one leaves after 7 has come in. So this is not possible. 7 comes in, occupies this position, one leave. So 173665 must have been the status at some point of time. And then one also leaves, making it blank. 73665. So I knew for a fact that 4 and 6 are SUVs. I also now know for a fact that 1, 2 and 7 are compact cars. 1, 2, 7 are compact cars. Because if any of them was an SUV, 6 would have come and occupied its position. If 2 was an SUV, 6 would have come and occupied it. If 1 was an SUV, you would have had 2 blank positions. If 7 was an SUV, it would not have fit in here. If 7 was an SUV, it would not have fit in here. 7 would have gone later. So now I know 4 and 6 are SUVs. 1 to 7 are compacts. So which of the following must be false? 2 is a compact. 2 is a compact is true. 4 is an SUV. 4 is an SUV is true. 7 is a compact. 7 is a compact is also true. So if these three are true, car 6 is a compact is false. We have figured out 6 is an SUV. Actually, I didn't know need to put in all this effort. My question was solved a lot earlier. All this effort was not required because very quickly I had figured out that 4 and 6 were SUVs. Are you guys okay with this? Okay, that's good to see. Thank you, Kishle, for sending across this question. Let's go ahead. So, an academy also offers an iconic plan in which you will be mentored directly by top B schools graduate who will help you plan your preparation and tell you about which exams to take, which colleges to fill and all of that. There is a scholarship test which will be held on 11th of July. It's a special one at 7 p.m. You can take part in that. Along with that, every Sunday, combat to hota hai. So this is a test which happens every Sunday at noon. They'll ask you for a referral code. Please use Honda in that. And you know, the toppers for this can get the 1-year subscription for essentially free. That being said, let's try out another question. Let's try out another question. So, long theory. This is from CAT 2005. Let me know when you are done with, this particular set. This particular slide, so that I can move on to the next one. Venkat is a stockbroker. He invested part of his money in four companies, A, B, C, D. Each of these companies belongs to a different industry: cement, IT, auto, and steel, in no particular order. At the time of investment, price of each stock was 100 rupees. Venkat purchased only one stock of these companies, expecting returns of 20, 10, 30, and 40 from A, B, C, D respectively. Okay. So, he invested A, B, C, and D, 100, 100, 100, and 100. His expected returns were, from A it was 20, from B it was 10, from C it was 30, from D it was 40. So this was his investment. These are his returns expected. Returns are defined as the change in the stock value after 1 year, expressed as a percentage of the initial value. During the year, two of these companies announced extraordinarily good results. One of these companies was cement or IT, while the other one was steel or auto. As a result, the stocks of these two companies were higher than the initially expected returns. Okay. So two of these companies, I don't know which two, but they gave higher than expected returns. For the company belonging to the cement or the IT industry, the returns were twice that was expected. Okay, so I don't know which one is cement or IT, but whichever one it was, so the max returns which you can expect, in this case, it'll be 140, 120, 160, and 180. So this is what will happen if you will have 2x returns. Then for the company belonging to the steel or auto industry, the returns were only 1.5 times of expected returns. So if they gave 1.5x, so instead of 20, it would have given 130. Instead of 110, it would have given 115. Instead of 130, it would have given 145. Instead of 120, it would have given 160. So these are the possible returns. For the remaining two companies, which did not announce extraordinary, the returns realized were the same as initially expected. Okay. So what should happen? What should happen is your total investment is 400 rupees. For two of them, these values will be there. So from this, you need to select two values. From this, you need to select one value. From this, you need to select one value. That is what will happen. Are you guys okay till here? This one will be from cement or IT, which is giving 2x returns. Company belonging to steel or auto. So steel or auto will give 1.5x returns. I don't know which one is which or what is going to happen. Are you okay with this? The data, everything is clear. Then I'll move on to the questions. Give me a thumbs up if you're okay with everything that I've done till here. Okay, if you have any doubts, please use the chat window. I'll be happy to clarify any doubts that you have. I've just put in the data. I don't know which to or where or what will happen. Let's see the questions. If Venkat earned a 35% return on average, so if he earned 35% on average, he started with 400. He must go to how much for a 35% return? 540? See, 35% of 400 is going to be 35 into 4, which is 70 into 2, which is 140 it needs to increase. So it should go to 540. Now, what you need to figure out is how can you get to 540 from here? 540 from here, what is the, you know, you'll have to check for various combinations. See, picking two from here, one from here, one from here, it'll be very, very difficult. It'll be very, very difficult. I'm not denying that, but I will consider, you know, max possible case, because 35% is a high return. Look at 20, 10, 30, 40, you're averaging 35. So that means you're getting high returns. So what is the maximum? If you have to select max, what will you do? So if you have to select maximum, which one will you do? For maximum, I will double the one which is best. So I will take 180. Then 1.5, I will do which is the second best, which is 145. The other two, I will do less. The other two, I will do less. So let's try that. How much is it? 180 plus 145 plus 110 and 120. How much does this come out as? 180 plus 145 plus 110 plus 120 comes out as 555. This comes out as 555. So this is the best possible scenario. This is the best possible scenario, which is 155. I need 540. So I just need 15 less. I need 15 less. So if I know I need 15 less, what can I do? See, one part that I realize is 1/13/4. I'm not sure what you mean. Oh, okay. Instead of 145, if I take 130, so then what will happen? Instead of 145, I change this to 130. Then this will also change, na? This will also change. Let's see if the options, the options will not help. So 180. 1.5x for A, okay. Then what? 130. So you want to take, tell me which ones do you want? 130 you want to take for A. Then 180 here, 110, 130 here. So 130, 110, 130. And 180, does this work? 130 A, B, C, and D. How much is this? This is 550. This is 550. So no, this doesn't work. I need to get to 540. How can I get to 540? That is what my question is. Let's see if, see, I know 145 should not come in. I know 145 should not come in and 115 should not come in because they will end in 5. they will end in 5 and my total will never be able to, you know, get to that. My total will never be able to get to that. I tried with 130. Let me try with 160 here. Let me try with 160 here. 160 here. If I take these two. So 120, 110, 120, 110, and then 160, 160. Does this work? 320, 440, 550. No, 550 again. Karthik is saying 130, 110 for A and B. 130, 110 for A and B. Then 140 for D and 160. 140 for D and 160. So D, C, B and A. Does this work? Does this work? Yes, it does. This is giving me a total of 540. This is 300. This is 540. So now I'm getting 540. Now you check which statements are true. So A is becoming 1.5x. So A becomes to steal an auto. B did not announce extraordinarily good results. We are saying B is 110. So B did not announce extraordinarily good results. A announced extraordinarily good results. A is going from 120 to 130. A is announcing extraordinarily good results. D did not announce extraordinarily good results. So D is 140, which is giving me 140. So D did not announce extraordinarily good results. So this is happening. All four are happening, but I don't have all four in the options. But I don't have all four in the options. That means there is another way to fill this. That means there is another way to fill this. So you now need to figure out what is the other way. This is one, but this is not the only way which is possible. A gives double, okay? And D returns 1.5. A gives double, D returns 1.5. I don't think that will work. We have tried that out, right? 130 is double, D gives 1.5, so 140, 160, this is what you are saying, Shreya, 140 from here, 160 from here, and then 130. Does this work? Yes, this one also works. This one also gives me 540. Now, in this one, which ones are satisfied? A belonged either to auto or steel. So A is giving 140. A is giving 140, so it's cement and IT. So no. B did not announce extraordinarily good results. B is not announcing extraordinarily good results. A announced extraordinarily good results. Yes, A is announcing extraordinarily good results. D did not announce extraordinarily good results. D has announced extraordinarily good results in this case. So in this case, 2 and 3 are true. So now, in one case, I am getting all 4 true. In one case, I am getting only 2 as true. So which of these statements is necessarily true? 2 and 3 only. Difficult set, not denying it, because you'll have to check for all possible combinations. You'll have to check for all possible combinations. In one case, the first case that I took, I got all 4 correct. In the next case that I took, I got only 2 correct, and that is why 2 should be the answer in the exam. Kishle, it is secondary what you should do in the exam or not. Obviously not, man. You cannot do this in the exam where you have to, you know, manipulate so much to get to 540. And this is just one question. We have more questions on this. Let's check. Now Venkat earned 38.75. 38.75 on 400 is how much? So 400, 38.75 is how much? It's 155. So that means 555. 555, 557. No, it's coming out as 555, Ashutosh. 555, I know. 555, thankfully, I know it is. How is it coming? So for 555, D is 180. How much is C? C is 145. And A and B are normal. A and B are normal. 120 and 110. In this case, what is happening? These are regular results. These are extraordinary results. 145. 145 belongs to steel or auto. 180. 180 belongs to cement or IT. I don't think you can get 555 any other way. I don't think you can get 555 any other way, because we have taken the max possible. We have taken the max possible. I don't think you will be able to get 555 any other way. So let's check this. C belong to auto or steel? Yes. D belong to auto or steel? No. A pronounced extraordinarily good results? No. B did not announce extraordinarily good results? Yes. So 1 and 4 are correct. Option 3 is my answer here. Option 3 is my answer here. Are you okay with this? So this became simple because we put in so much effort in the last one. This became simple because we put in so much effort in the last one. We already found out the maximum here. Should I go to the next one? Company C belonged to cement or IT and did announce extraordinarily good results. So from A, B, C and D, C announced cement or IT. So cement or IT is C. So C is 160. So C I know is 160 for sure. I don't know about A, B and D. I don't know about A, B and D. Now, Venkat earned not more than 36.25. So now if I want to maximize, if I want to maximize the returns, so double cement or IT is double that we have already taken care for C. Which one will be 1.5? Which one will be 1.5? D will be 1.5 because D is the biggest value. So make it 1.5, 160. A and B, they did not announce good results. So 110, 120. So A and B are 120, 110. 120, 110. What is the total? What is the total? This is the max. So this is 320, 320 plus 230. So this is 550. 550 is how much? 550, if I divide by 400, that is a return of 37.5%. This is a return of 37.5%. So he can get 37.5% by this way, 160, 160, 120 and 110. We are given he earned not more than 36.25. So this is false. He can earn 37.5%. Not less than 33.35. Okay. So now let me calculate the minimum also. Now you can calculate the minimum also. So this is 160. This is for sure. When I'm going to make it the minimum, I will maximize B. So that is 115. A and D, not any change. A and D was 120 and 140. A and D was 120 and 140. So how much is the total here? So this is 300 and 235. So 535. How are you getting 520? Shreya, how are you getting 520? I'm getting 535 as the minimum. C remains fixed at this 1.5 returns I've done for B. 1.5 returns I've done for B. No, we cannot do that. We already know that C is in cement or IT. Shreya, we are not allowed to pick the 1B double. We are not allowed to pick the 1B double. So 535, what is the return here? It is 33.75%. So the minimum return is 33.75. So this is correct. Venkat earned not less than 33.75%. Yes, the minimum we have found out for Venkat is coming out to be indeed 33.75. If Venkat earned 33.75, if he earned 33.75, that means this case, A announced extraordinarily good results. No, A did not. A did not. If Venkat earned 33.75, B belonged to Auto or Steel. Yes, B is the one which has announced 15 extra 50%. B is the one which has gone to 115. B is the one which belongs to Steel or Auto. So yes, 4 is correct, 2 is correct, 4 is correct, option 2 comes out as my answer here. Are you okay with this? You calculate the maximum, you calculate the minimum, and based upon that, you get to the answer. Okay. Last one, what is the minimum average return that Venkat could have earned? So minimum, so now when I have to do the minimum, now I am allowed, so Shreya, you remember, you were saying that minimum for Venkat is 30%. I will now take the minimum case. I will now take the minimum case. I have A, B, C, D. I have A, B, C, D. I'll double. You know, let me use the green color for minimum. So minimum. So 110 for B. That's the minimum. I'll make it double. So B, 120. This is 2x, then 1.5x for this one, A, because A is the next smaller value. So from 120, it goes to 130. C and D, no change. C and D, no change. How much were C and D? 130, 140. So what is the total? 250 plus 270, that is a total of 520, which is a total of 30%. So the minimum that he could have earned is indeed 30%. Double B, 1.5 XA. Are you okay with this? So again, complicated question. Fourth was easy. See, the ones where you had to calculate the minimum and maximum. When you had to calculate the minimum and maximum, question 2 and question 4 were easy, but 1 and 3, where there were so many conditions, were really, really hard. Why am I discussing this question with you? The only reason is because I want you guys to learn how to actually evaluate a set. Now, after solving this, you know, you might have realized that this is complex and this will take time. But how are you going to make that decision early on? You're going to make that decision based upon the way the questions are structured. Look at the questions. Which of the following is necessarily true? And then there are four statements. Again, necessarily true, four statements. And among those four, then again, you need to pick two. Among those four, then again, you need to pick two. Multiple conditions. If this happens, then what all? So this is the only direct question. In four questions, there is only one direct question. You looked at this set, you would have realized probably early enough that in the options, there are so many cases to be taken. And whenever you have such a scenario where you need to take a large number of cases, it will always be problematic. You know, I don't know if you are doing this in RC or not, that when you look at an RC passage, I recommend students to maybe spend, you know, half a minute or a minute just having a look at the questions. Because in RC, as much as in LR, it often helps if, you know, you have a look at the questions and you see how many options are there and, you know, whether you have direct questions or not, Even the previous one, Now, in this one also, it's not really a very good set to, you know, attempt, because there is no predefined information. All the sets which have predefined information that, okay, there is a table which you need to fill. If you can fill it, great. If you cannot fill it, it's problematic. Here, in each and every question, you need to put more effort, you need to calculate. Whenever you have sets like this, where you need to put effort to calculate each and every question, those type of sets are not recommended. Whenever you have, you know, a games and tournament question, fine, put in how many goals you are scoring or what is happening. Those questions, grid arrangement questions, linear arrangement questions, when you can, you know, you might not get the complete thing, but you get a bulk of it. Those sort of questions are always, always preferred. Otherwise, you will have to keep on calculating based upon what's happening in each and every question. And that's not what I would recommend you to do in the exam. That being said, there are multiple batches which are starting. My recommendation to you would be for especially, you know, guys who are starting their prep, instead of the 14th batch, which is kind of a crash course, it'll be better if you go in for the 7th or the 10th July batch. You can use the coupon code HANDA when you are enrolling. And for those of you who are looking at CAT 2020, Rashi, for you, I would recommend that you have a look at these couple of batches which are starting specifically for CAT 2022. Since you are already enrolled, shouldn't really be a problem. So there was one more set that I had for today. Now, for example, now this is a set. I'm not discussing it today. I'll discuss it in episode 3. Now, this particular set, let me just quickly evaluate whether I'll do it or not. Okay, I see some information, conditions are given, a table is given, some data in the table is missing. I love these questions where there is a table and some data is missing, because I already know and understand that I'll have to fill this table up. More conditions are there. And look at the questions. What percentage? No, cannot be determined. No, 1 and 2, 3 and 4. Number of vote cast. Perfect 4 answers. This has some conditions, but only 2. Which one of the following must be true? Not very difficult. Fourth one is also a direct question. So this is the sort of set. I have no idea about the set. I'll read the set, then take a decision on it. But looking at just the question, superficial information, this looks good to me. So this is a set which we will discuss in episode 3. Episode 3 is 7 PM Saturday. Let me see if I can give you guys the link for it. Guys, are you able to see the link on my profile? Because whenever I try to see it, I don't know, it shows some older classes. I'm not very sure how exactly, you know, the user interface works. So let me try to give you the link for episode 3. Okay, I'm pinning it. You guys can click on it. This is the link for episode 3. You can notify or something so that you can join whenever the next class is. There is a new channel on YouTube that we guys have started, which is to cater to students who are in class 12. You can search that with Crack Management Exams. In case you find any sort of a bug on, you know, on the app or something is not working or any issues with the content, there is a link where you can report that as well. Unacademy, as you might know by now, has an Ask a Doubt feature. Click a picture, send it to us. Me or someone from our team will clarify that for you. And if you have any further questions, anything else that you want to discuss about your preparation, please drop me an email on ravihanda@gmail.com. I will pick it up in an upcoming class. And on that note, I'd like to end today's class. I'll request you guys to please provide positive feedback. The more positive feedback that I get, the more classes, especially for the free ones, how the evaluation process works is more free classes on better feedback, more paid courses on better feedback. So they get managed that way. So I'll request you to please provide a positive feedback at the end of this one. And on that note, Bob the Builder, I hope I'll find out your real name soon. You can always send me an email if you have any questions or your songs. Bye, everyone. Bye, guys.